So guys, going to the unboxing. This is what we get to look at. This is a Mi Max phone, which is like almost the whole box of it. Like it's the full big box, which is in the frame. You can see. Just remove the phone and keep it outside. This is the phone. You can see how big it is. You can check my hand, and you can just check how big it is. And yeah. So this is what the phone is. It's the biggest phone I have ever seen, and the camera has a cover which you can remove it after you start using it. It has a fingerprint scanner, and it has a scratch guard basically, which I will surely remove after some time. Well, let's see what we have in the box. We have a SIM card removal tool, which I would like to open now, because as it is, my brother will be installing his SIM card into this cell. So we will just check what kind of it has. Well, this is the charger, and this is the cord for charging. It had a seal which I removed, and yeah, it has nothing written on it. Well, it has written on it that Xiaomi adapter power. It has AC 100 to 240 volts and 0.35 amps. Well, it charges at 2 amps, but I don't think it will be giving a full 2 amp charge. Well, that's what we get into the box, and nothing else. We don't get a headphone or anything like that. I will just remove this stuff outside and keep, because we don't need anything else. I'll just throw away the manuals and all stuff. Well, coming to the welcome, my brother is looking at me like, why are you throwing it? Well, we have the phone right now, and yeah, I would like to open the SIM slot and check what it has. Oh wow, so this is the slim slot that we get, and it's written SIM 1 and SIM 2. One is the nano one, second is the micro one. So it has a micro and a nano SIM, which you can see. I'll just zoom in. Okay. Zoom in. Okay. Yes. So this is what we get. And yeah, you can see this is a nano and a micro. Well, this is what we get. We'll just install the SIM card and just switch it on, and let's check out the phone. So guys, switching on the phone. Yes, this is a big phone, and I couldn't reach the button. It takes couple of minutes at the first boot, I think, like as usual, like on any device. Even after the after you update your iOS, you get so it's like you need to give some time. Okay, so well guys, I will just remove this screen protector and continue the video. So guys, due to the brightness, I suppose you cannot see what's written on the phone exactly, but I will just remove the scratch guard and like continue with whatever it is. Like I cannot focus much on this. This is like a language, and I have selected English and UK. Well, I will just go to India, and I'll just register the phone. It's India right now. And yeah, setting the locale, that's it's setting the location for itself. And yeah, it takes some time. I haven't connected to anything. I suppose this battery life also should be like a big time profitable on this phone. This is a pretty big phone. You can see like it has some warning labels behind it, and it says as India SAR 1G limit 1.6 something, like the SAR notifications and all stuff. For your safety, do not disable the battery without specialized tools stuff. I'll just remove the camera protection. It's not a protection. Well, camera looks to be pretty good. I don't know the quality yet. I will just check the quality and post some pictures from this mobile. Okay, focus. Okay, I will want my camera to focus on this. So guys, coming to the next setting, we have a keyboard setting. I will just check on Swift keyboard. I will just go with it. I will just set up the Wi-Fi I have and come back to you. So guys, after going through some of the settings and setting up the MI account and the Google account and many of the other stuff, I have skipped everything so that my brother sets it up according to him. Well, it's asking me choose a theme. It's like default, rose, high life, ocean breeze or pink blush. Well, I will be going with default because I like simple stuff. Well, complete the setup. Yes, you are ready to rock. And it's asking me allow Google to activate the security services and all stuff like that, blah blah blah, Google X services. And now it's loading all the apps. This process is quite long if you consider considering an Apple device or any other Android device like my Eureka. I didn't had any of this stuff. Like, it doesn't matter actually, but yeah, it's a long process to like set up a phone like this, and there's no other option to do it because actually I just skipped the MI part, so it doesn't matter. Well, it's taking time and I don't know how much more time it will take. You just wait and watch. It's like 1 minute now or half minute. I don't know, I haven't made such reviews before, and not at least for a phone or a mobile device. I have been working on RC stuff and I don't know how to compare this stuff lately. I was into mobiles and Android devices earlier, but nowadays I am just out of the technology now. Well, it's taking time. It's still taking a lot of time. I suppose it's downloading some stuff from internet as I have connected my Wi-Fi. But I'm not sure about it. It might be downloading something from the app store, the pre-installed, like the apps and all stuff. I'm not sure. And even I cannot pull down any of the window, or I cannot do anything else. I cannot go back, or I cannot do anything. Nothing works actually. It's just loading. It's just loading apps. I'll just keep the phone over here and let's see when it completes. Okay guys, so the setup is complete after 2 minutes, and yes, the phone is loaded. It's showing me the gesture controls, I suppose. Yes, it's showing me pinch to home screen and all stuff. Well, the screen is too large. You can see my hand and you can see the phone. It's a big phone. And okay, it's showing me it's his birthday today. And yes, happy birthday to him. Well, he has 3 messages. Activate MI message, which lets receiver and MI user without entering charges. Okay, MI has a good service which provides you to send messages and you don't need to pay for that, I think. At least like iMessages, I suppose. I'm activating the service. Verify, allow. I've done everything. I don't know. He might not like that stuff, but yeah. Okay, so this is what we have. Hangouts and all stuff. Everything is working cool. I'll just run through what all I normally browse, like whatever I do normally. I have just loaded his contacts and his videos and all stuff. He has some videos, he has some cartoons over here. Well, you may look at this. It's a big screen. The whole, like, you can consider an iPhone 6s over here and a phone. So this is my iPhone 6s and this is the MI Mi Max Prime. So this is the video quality. I feel it's good quality. I don't know the video quality on this. He has it on his phone. I don't know what all he watches. And yes, everything is loaded. I have also installed his memory card on the 128 GB internal, so everything is there. Well, we'll just go through the settings and we'll check everything else. Well, I'm most of the time I do other stuff, and this is the marshmallow game which we can play, and yeah, so I will like playing some of the games. We can just press on the model number and Android version, and you can just play. It's 6.0.1 Mi Max. Okay, everything is good to go with it right now. It's showing that it's 1.8 gigahertz octa-core max, 4 GB RAM, and 120 GB total of memory, which I am getting 117 GB of available data that I can store. That is like around 10 GB of data has been used by the internal processor services, approx 10 GB. Well, everything else is good to go, and I don't think anything bad about the phone. I was always positive about MI phones. I have used the Redmi Note 3 Prime before. Sorry, the Redmi 3S. I'm very sorry. Well, everything else is good. I don't think it will ever hang. Like, if I use it, it will surely hang someday. Like, even my 6S does hang sometimes. It has the basic stuff over here, so nothing great to see in this. Well, the image quality, I would like to check in. Well, it shows. Okay, just by clicking on the button, you can just click. It shows a button, it just focuses and it clicks. Well, these are the photos that I took just now. I will just post it. I will just take some more photos and I will post it if possible. Well, it has some of the color modes by which I can choose colors, and I can. Oh, wow. This is something trans I can see. You can check what happened over here. I can do a lot of color differentiation which is not even there on my iOS. It has a mirror fisheye effect and all stuff. This is very great for some photographics and stuff. So yeah, this is nice. I didn't knew about it. This is the front cam. I have a setup over here, and yeah, this is me. Well, everything is done, and I will just take a snap. And it's even showing my age. That's the face age. That is 30 male. I am just 24. Okay, now I will just like to play with this stuff. It's showing 30 male. Okay, that's good. It has good colors. It has a timer. It has an audio selection and all stuff. I don't know how did I set it up. Like, how did I do this? Oh, okay. So you can set a camera, like the front cam or the back cam, for a specific mode, and you can just continue with it. Okay, the modes: panorama, timer, audio, manual mode, straighten and beautify, HDD and tilt shift. Well, these are the stuff. Well, it has a torch even. Like, while clicking the photos, you can have a torch on and off. I will just keep it to auto, SDR on, auto on. Like, whenever possible, it will take SDR and it will just process the video fields and also. Well, the video, I don't know what quality it is. It just supports a good quality. I don't know. The front video is even good. The camera is better. The front camera for video is good, but it doesn't support low light, I suppose, because I don't have any light over here. So the front camera is not that good for low light productions and all stuff. Well, my basic review for this is, like, it's a good phone, but it's a very big phone. And I know this would have been a very boring review for you guys, but this is what I could do. Like, this is not my domain actually, and I have never done this. And yeah, it has a fingerprint reader, which is very big. I don't know, I won't be using this phone. It's like, it won't even fit my pocket. I will just like to show you. It won't even fit my pocket. See, it won't even fit my pocket. So it's very big. Like, I don't know who uses this phone. And sorry guys. So yeah, that's it. That's about the Redmi Mi Max Prime. So guys, I hope you like the video, and I don't know how I review this stuff, but yeah, this is new for me and I'm just trying it out because my brother bought this phone. Yeah, so that's what about the Mi Max Prime, and I suppose this is the, like, this is one of the first phones to be shipped to my brother, and it was his birthday, so thank you Mi Mi, thank you Amazon for shipping it very fast to us. It was on the back, like back order or something. They just tried to deliver it on 25. They just gave me a date of 25, and yes, they shipped it today. Well, the next thing I would like to tell is that I have exchanged this phone for a Sony Ultra T2, for which I got 4,500 rupees. So this phone costed me about 15,000, and the original cost of this phone is around 20,000 rupees. That is like the actual price for this, if you go, is like 19,999. So guys, stay tuned for more RC videos and all stuff. So guys, there is a second space. This is a new feature that I have seen in Androids, like I don't have in my iOS phone. Well, this second space allows you to create a second user space, like we have it on Windows, like a second user to use it, and we can have a separate separate memory and separate RAM and optimization stuff in this. You can just press second space. That's what it was deleting right now, because I had created a second space and without a password and all stuff, so I have deleted it so that two people using a single phone can use it properly. That's all about the phone, and yeah, so pretty much you can just buy the phone. It's very nice. You can get it from Amazon. I have linked it in the description. Sorry for the diversion on this phone. I don't know why I made this video, but I made it. Thank you guys. Bye.